Hello, everyone. I am so happy. I just got back from watching Fast 9, my number one most hyped for movie of not just 2021, but of 2020 as well, since this was supposed to be released last year but got delayed due to COVID. And yes, the wait was worth it. I am not ashamed at all to say that the Fast and Furious series is my all-time favorite film franchise. I love each and every one of them. It'll be hard for me to talk about Fast 9 without giving any spoilers, but I had such a great time going to see this. Much like the rest of the series, this movie is dumb. It's dumb and ridiculous. The action is over the top and the dialogue is corny, but it is so much fun that I just don't care. They even start to become self-aware in this movie and talk about all the impossible shit they've gone through and how they're basically invincible. I've gone through 9 movies with these characters and I've loved all of them since the beginning, and I am 100% willing to follow them through whatever adventures they go on. Not for a second was I bored or uninvested during this movie. They continue to top themselves with the final action set pieces, and I kind of like how they have established this big bad that clearly the series will end on. Although I feel like at this point, Cypher is going to turn into one of those comedic villains that constantly try to rule the world, but we, the audience, don't take them seriously at all. Like Ripto from Spyro or Frieza from Dragon Ball Z. We all know from the trailers that Han is back in this one, but the way they explain it kind of crossed the line for me, and I wasn't a big fan of the explanation. I was also kind of lost as to what the villain's motivations were. If John Cena was still so pissed about being exiled from the Toretto family that he wants to help take over the world, that's just petty, man. The last thing is not necessarily something I didn't like, but these movies are just not the same without Paul. He brought a special kind of performance and energy to the franchise that will never even come close to matching. And of course, I am fully aware there is absolutely nothing, literally anyone, can do about that. I also miss seeing Hobbs, who was easily my favorite character of Fast 5. It's a shame what's going on between Dwayne and Vin, and I hope they bring him back for the finale, since, of course, there is this whole other villain we were introduced to in Hobbs and Shaw. Will anything ever come of that? Who knows? But regardless, Fast 9 is a lot of fun, and I was not disappointed. I got exactly what I wanted. Most importantly, they finally brought back two characters who I have been waiting to see since Tokyo Drift. And no, I'm not talking about Han. And so therefore, I am giving Fast 9 an 8 out of 10. I'm so happy.